Lord and his wife.
Amen.
They are not being elected to be just a financial decision maker, but a servant leader, a helper in the ministry. And all of you, I, as pastor, have seen a servant's heart. And I know you're going to labor as a faithful servant. I didn't just pick you because you're my friend. I didn't just pick you because I like it. I picked you because you showed something. Smith, who's the deacon at the church you came from, and I know it was a great position, and I watched you. I watched your faithfulness. That's why you said, you know,
amen.
Who you like and all the rest of it. I asked this brother 4 years ago,
amen.
And he told me, you know, he wasn't ready. And I took that, because if you're not ready, you just say,
amen.
But he grew into it. And that's why he said it. All right? You've been on trial for some time. Been watching Moses ever since I came. Ever since he came. Corn. There. Didn't pick Bell the first time because I needed to clean up some rough edges. Yeah. Good man. All right? I watch you from afar and up close. You have exemplified your servant's heart. Okay? This church has seen your desire to help and be a servant.
Yes.
If I don't want to complain from anybody, I'd have held back.
Amen.
Not one complaint from nobody. That's good news. Alright? All of you have a good testimony, and you need a testimony. You need a testimony. Your actions as deacons will reflect upon Christ and his body more than others. You represent this church. Wherever you go, you represent this church and me. So you live a God-honoring life in this community, in the church, and you make God your Savior. Because there are many going to look upon you and wonder how that affect you. And your actions will show why. If you fail, you'll bring dishonor upon the name of Jesus, our Lord, and the entire church.
Amen.
All right? Let me be honest with you. People look at deacons more than they themselves. So you've been picked out, they picked on. Deacons' mistakes are magnified. And sometimes their good qualities go unrecognized. Often deacon carries very great responsibilities, but the privileges and rewards far outweigh the burdens. Paul tells Timothy, for they that have used the office of a deacon will purchase to themselves a good decree and great boldness in the faith which is in Christ Jesus. The mission of the church is to be witnesses of Christ, first in our homes, in our communities, on our jobs. The Holy Spirit is our comforter. The Bible is our guide. We are a church that's willing to work, working to win. Through evangelism outreach, educational empowerment, economic development, and political involvement. Now, to ask you some questions, I want you to answer. I will. Or if you don't answer, if you don't want to do it, don't stop it. And I'll watch you and see you on back to your seat. I thought I'd get a little laugh. Are you committed to this mission statement? Do you promise before God and this church of Jesus Christ that you will uphold the truth and doctrines of God's word? Will you be a living example of Jesus Christ in this church and in this community? And on your job? Will you be faithful and regular attendance? That was a little slow now. Will you be wholehearted in your giving to support this church? Will you be open-minded in the planning and growth of this church? Will you be patient in seeking the solution to the problems that may occur in this church? Will you seek to serve with a servant's heart? Will you assist the pastor in implementing and carrying out the ministers of this church? Will you honestly seek God's guidance and His will for this church?
I will.
All right, now I need to talk to the church. Samuel Bell Sr., Stefan Cohen, Darius Hicks, Patrick Moses, Class Hill Sr., Leonard Smith, and Steve Martin have been set apart by God to fulfill a vital ministry in this church. They need your support and affirmation. Do you as a church promise before God and these new deacons that you will pray for them and encourage them as they do the same for you? All right. I want these brothers to stay and come right here in the middle. Get on their knees.
Amen.
I want all the preachers to come. All these deacons to come. Coming out of the way. What a good idea. Okay, God moves just back. Actually, you can go back to your seats if you like. I didn't need the preachers and the deacons. Preachers and deacons. Preachers and deacons. Oh, lay hands on them.
Amen.
Lay hands on them. It's my life.
Yes.
Give you praise and honor. It's in Jesus' name.
Amen.